morning class. My name is Martin and I'll be your moderator for this evening class. Welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a non-profit, non-denominational, religious and scientific research organization dedicated to showing you proof of the existence of Yahweh or Elohim and the operation of his eternal purpose, pattern and plans, operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio, India, in 1931. We were later on incorporated in the state of California, India, in 1958. Since that time, we have established branch schools throughout the United States, Canada, Africa, and several other foreign countries throughout the world. Our local IDMR Kingston branch school was established in Kingston, Jamaica, in the year 1988, and our Spanish one branch in the year 1994. Now let me introduce to you two of the officials of our Spanish one branch. We have our Dean, Dr. Donna Mitchell, and our Superintendent, Dr. Irving Grant. Now, in this school, we teach by the true, correct, and original name and title of our Heavenly Father, the Word, our Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of our Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted with Lord. The true title for the Word, our Son, is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted with God. The true name of the Holy Spirit, manifested in our outward physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted with Jesus Christ. Now, Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that your Lord's many and God's many. But we now know that each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means that Elohim is a title that our Heavenly Father Yahweh chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia will show proof that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any characters or letters in their alphabet that will produce a sound made by this letter J. And neither was there a letter J in our English alphabet until some 1400 years after the death, burial, and resurrection of Yahshua the Messiah. Therefore, making such names as Jesus, Jah, and Jehovah impossible and incorrect rendering to the true and correct name of our Heavenly Father and His Son. Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Now this is a mosaic chart, and may I direct your attention. Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state He is incomprehensible, inscrutable, invisible, and inconceivable. Yahweh is the ultimate source, is the infinite and immaculate substance, is the limits and bounds of everything. Now here we have Yahweh, symbolized in his pure spirit state on this chart as a cloud. However, Yahweh is not a cloud. Yahweh merely chose a cloud to symbolize or to depict himself because a cloud has no particular descriptive shape or form. We have drawn this orange fiery cloud all around the edges of this chart to show proof, or that everything on this chart abides within the cloud. In like manner, does everything in the universe abide within the pure spirit state of Yahweh? Now Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, he took on shape and form, right within himself as Elohim. This is the Word, our Son, the super incorporeal being of the great heavenly anthropomorphic being. This is having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. In this form, he can only be seen in divine vision and understood in divine revelation. Later on, this self-same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plain as Yahshua the Messiah, who the world erroneously called Jesus Christ. Now, there is only one name given unto salvation, and we must know this name. So the simple yet intelligent question we should ask ourselves: what was the name of the Savior during the time he walked the earth plain? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of our Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called a divine pattern because it's Yahweh's pattern. Now after Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, Yahweh called Moses on top Mount Sinai and showed him this threefold pattern in a vision. Yahweh later on instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court round about. These three compartments make up this one type like a pattern. In our schools, we go about showing you proof of that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes this pattern. Now in our schools, we have 10 primary constitutional aims and objectives, and they are as follows. One is to help you find and know Yahweh or Elohim as he really is and as he actually exists. Two is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without a distinction of race, nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Three is to investigate the unexplained spirit law, or the so-called law of nature and the powers latent in man. Four is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative to religion, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Five is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Six is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose, operating throughout the dispensation and ages. Seven is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the dragon, the devil, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth throughout the dispensation of time. Eight is to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered to the sons and the children of Yahweh. Nine is to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained, there is no other name given among men whereby man must be saved, save the name of Yahshua the Messiah. 10 is to inherit eternal life now, in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah, with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth.
Junior, will you pray? I'd like to read 1 Corinthians 15.
We have prayer this evening by Dr. Junior Williams, and our scripture lesson is taken from 1 Corinthians 15, 1 to 4, read by Dr. Michael Mitchell.
Good evening, brother.
Good evening.
Father Yahshua, we thank you once more for this privilege to be in class, to learn of your purpose, pattern, and plan. And we are asking you just to let us observe it and continue to learn of you. And you know, if anyone here for the first, we'll show them that you really is. You know,
hallelujah.
Good evening. This evening's reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 1 to 4, read from the Holy Day Bible containing the Holy Day version of the Old Testament and its fulfillment, critically compared and revised by A.P. Traynor of the Scriptural Research Association. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 1 to 4. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the glad tidings which I preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received, how that Yahshua the Messiah died for our sins, according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day, according to the scriptures. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Our speaker this evening will be our dean, Dr. Danamichel.
Good evening, and welcome to another spiritual lecture given to you by the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research Incorporated. We are a school and we are not a church. And in this school, we go about showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua Messiah, being our Savior, our Redeemer. Prior to this divine vision and revelation, we were told that Lord God, Jesus Christ, Jah, Allah, Buddha, is the Savior. But we don't. Did anyone prove to you that Jesus Christ was the Savior? Is the Savior? What witnesses? What evidence? I look in the King James Version, and it's a version, and I see Lord God and Jesus Christ. But it is the version. What was in the original? I didn't know to ask that question, but now I understand. What was recorded in the original? Who was King James? Was he inspired by the Creator to translate? He translated, and if you read the first part of the King James Version of the Bible, King James says, translated. You have the King James Version?
Yes.
The first page, please.
Okay.
Yes.
It says, translated out of the original tongue.
Stop. What's the meaning of translate?
Change.
And what was in the original tongue? Who inspired King James to translate? Was he a prophet?
No.
Is his name in the scriptures a prophet? I know about Isaiah, Zechariah, Nehemiah, Zephaniah, who Yahweh ordained as prophet. Find the one that says King James was a prophet. No, so we have a problem with that. He says, translated out of Greek, out of the original tongue. What was in the original tongue? Can you translate a name? Can the messages be translated?
Yes,
but can you translate a name? So King James should have said, translating and transliterating. Because a name can only be transliterated. A name cannot be translated. So right here we have a lot of problems. So he admitted or he's confessing that he did translate the name. And go and look it up in your dictionary. Translate means to change. Suppose I was living in Russia and I write a letter. My name in Russian is Maria. When you get the letter in English, will you change my name to Pamela?
No.
Or something else?
No.
So what if you change my name?
It's no longer you.
What if you're looking for me to transact some business and I gave you my name as Maria, but as I reach Russia, I change my name and you want me to pay you to Pamela Brown? Would you be able to track me?
No.
Now, those people have had to say that Pablo in Cuba is Paul in English. How could Pablo in Cuba be Paul in English? No, I leave Cuba as Pablo with my passport. I land in Jamaica. What is in my passport?
Pablo.
I stay here 2 weeks. What is still in my passport?
Pablo.
When will my name become Paul?
No time.
By whom, by what, when? Can you just translate my name by just arriving in Jamaica?
No.
Fidel, so dunce people, just like what dunce people say 72 names. Philippians 2:9 says, he has highly exalted him and given him a name. You see propaganda and being dunce? There's a physical dunce and there's a spiritual dunce. And this is a spiritual vision. So dunce man come and tell a man that, you know, Mr. Pablo Mendez, you are now Paul Mendez. He buys a piece of land, he put Paul Mendez on the title, stupid. His passport says Pablo Mendez. Any little rupture when the police come and say, no, it's not your land. Because there's nothing to identify you as that. So names can, and that's what King James was a dunce. That's what he did, he translated the names. So you have equivalent and you have equal. Suppose I give you 5 diamonds and you give me 5 regular stones.
Equivalent.
One is equivalent, one is equal. So equality is different from equivalent. Even in maths. That's a simple thing, you know. So it's equal for you to give me 5 stone and 5, but it is not the same value. So if a person translates your name, it cannot be the same value. You must lose your identity and your belongings. If you want to translate your name to my bank account, fine. I have not from you, but I'm explaining. So some people say, yes, translate. Suppose Paul goes to Spain, and you're listening to the race. All of a sudden, you're ching-fai-foo. And you say, wait, what up the boat? I don't know your boat's name. But a dunce man come and say, yeah, translate his name, and you accept it. Like, no problem. If you translate the person's name, you have lost sight. So that's what King James did. When he came, when he opened the manuscript scroll and he saw the name Yahweh, he translated it to Lord. When you read etymology of the Lord, it is British, ancient, the Baal Adonai Molech, and the Phoenician and Egyptian idol. When he came across the title Elohim, which Yahweh chose for him, which is a pluralistic title, he translated it to God of the Assyrian and German. The Assyrian spelled it G-A-U-D-R-G-A-W-D. The Germans spell it G-O-T-T or G-O-D-D. The English borrow the same word from the Germans and they drop one of the D and call it God, an idol, an Assyrian idol. When he came across Yahshua Messiah or Messiah, he translated it to Jesus Christ. Jesus drew up an E, a Babylonian water god. Zeus is supreme god of the Greeks. Christ come from Christos or Krishna. an Hindu idol sun god. Micah 5 and 2. Isaiah 8 and 20. Now, there's a prophecy in the same King James Version. And it tells you where the Messiah will be coming from. Listen to the prophecy. It says, of Bethlehem.
Micah 5 and 2.
Yes.
But thou, Bethlehem.
It says, thou, Bethlehem. Is Bethlehem in London?
No.
Is it geographically located in Assyria?
No.
Or any of these, Greece? No. It says, thou, Bethlehem.
Ephrata. Don't thou be little among thousands of Judah.
Of Yahudans. There isn't any J up to today in Hebrew. Mm-hmm. And the letter J is the last letter added to the English alphabet. When King James wrote the first King James Version, he didn't write about Jesus Christ. He wasn't called King James, he was Prince Hines. God, there wasn't a letter J. The J is the last letter. Even if you look at the $500 bill in Jamaica, look at that, the island of Jamaica, it is called Amica. God, there was no J. If you go to the churches and you look up to today in the church, you see I-N-R-I. God, there wasn't a letter J. Jesus Nazarenus Rex Iodiorum, which they translate as Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. So it says the Messiah will be coming from Bethlehem. What language do they speak there?
Hebrew.
So it says, out of Bethlehem, really?
Out of thee shall he come forth unto me.
Yes.
That is to be ruler in Israel.
Did he say he will be an Israelite?
Yeah.
All right.
Whose goings forth have been from of old.
From when?
From of old.
From when was he called Yeshua?
From everlasting.
From of old?
From everlasting.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
So from the days of eternity. Now, it says in Revelation that the mark of the beast is the number of his name. And it is 666. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, second 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a third 6. You'll be the judge of that. So, another question I have for you. King James says that the Creator is the Lord. King is a title, isn't that so?
Yeah.
Especially for our visitors. Lord is a title. And then, which is higher in rank?
King.
It doesn't matter, it matters?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes,
if you have a master's and you have a PhD or a certificate, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, I can pay you the same money.
No.
The titles matter because Lord is below the rank of King. King James said that he's King James and the Creator is the Lord. Can Queen Elizabeth be called Lady Elizabeth? That will be demoting her title. Is Pope a title?
Yes. Yeah.
Is King above Pope or Pope above King? I just
Pope. Pope above King.
So is Lord below Pope?
Yes.
Is Lord below King?
Yes.
Is Lord below Emperor?
Yes.
Tsar? Lord is below Tsar?
Yeah.
So how King James didn't give the Creator one of those titles? And he gave himself the King and the Creator as the Lord. This is an insult. Now tell me something. Look at this analogy. So what if I go to England right now and say to Queen Elizabeth, you are no longer Queen Elizabeth, you are Lady Elizabeth. Isn't there be a problem?
Yeah.
I don't want to call her Queen. It matters? It matters?
Yes,
it matters. It matters to Queen. To the Queen. But you see this propaganda, and these lies in hypocrisy, which has become tradition. Salvation is not tradition. Yeshua says, know the truth and the truth. See our original version of the King James. This is a copy of the original version of the King James, the first one that he did. And there's no Jesus Christ. See? Now, another question I have for the class. Is the name Jesus Christ in the beginning of the book?
No.
Is it in the middle of the book?
No.
Where do you find the name Jesus Christ?
Andrew.
But in John 5:46, Yahshua said, which he called Jesus Christ, for I do believe Moses would have been for Moses wrote up? How many books did Moses write?
Five.
Did he write about Jesus Christ?
No.
Can you find Jesus Christ in the writing of Moses?
No.
Is there a book of Joshua?
Yes.
Joshua is Yahshua. So let us look at the King James Version, and then we're going to correct it to the Holy New Version. Now you find out that the one that says, without a prophetic vision, the people perish. He says, To the law,
and to the prophets,
and to the testimony of prophets,
If they speak not according to this word,
who is Yahweh Elohim,
it is because there is no light in
it
them.
It is because there is no Holy Spirit in them. Luke 24, verse 25.
Then he said unto them,
Yeshua appeared to the two on the road of Emmaus, and he said unto them, read.
O fools and slow of heart.
He didn't call them a fool to insult them, but to instruct them. Read.
To believe all that the prophets have spoken.
To believe all that the prophets have spoken.
Ought not the Messiah to have suffered these things?
So suffer a death and a burial, but he didn't suffer a resurrection. Read.
And to enter into his glory.
So he resurrected gloriously. Read.
And beginning at Moses.
So the Messiah took them back to the writing of Moses. Listen carefully now. Read.
And beginning at Moses and all the prophets.
And all the prophets.
He expounded unto them in all the scriptures. In all the scriptures.
In all the scriptures.
The things concerning himself.
But there's no Jesus Christ back there in the writing of Moses. So all the Messiah is speaking about expounding in the writing of Moses, the things concerning Israel. Because here's not Jesus, but here's Yahshua. Who was Joshua. In his first coming, he came with the same name. And he said he has declared the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things which are not yet done. And he said, Yahshua, Hebrews 30 verse 8 says, Yahshua the same yesterday, today, and forever. So in his first coming, he came as Yahshua, which they call Joshua. There's no book of Joshua, there's no book of Jesus Christ. There's no trace of any Jesus Christ from Genesis to Malachi. You write a book about me, and at the end of the book you put my name as Jesus Christ. But to prove that it is wrong, when you look in the beginning of the book, you see Yahshua right through. You see Yahshua in Genesis, in Numbers 13 chapter. You see Yahshua as the book of Yahshua right through to the end. So there's no way you could compose a book about a man. And in the beginning of the book, you call him Yahshua, which they call Joshua. At the end, you call him Jesus Christ. That makes no sense at all. And he said, I am coming the volume of the book.
Verse 44.
Get me that scripture that says, I am coming the volume of the book. It is written of me. 44. Continue. 44.
Verse 44.
Yes.
And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you,
yes,
while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled.
What must be fulfilled? What's the meaning of fulfilled?
Finish.
Is it the same as established?
No.
Was he setting up a Christian example for us?
No.
He said that all things must be fulfilled,
which were written in the law of Moses.
Give me an example of what is written in the law of Moses.
Baptist, Sabbath, Passover.
But you should have seen the word fulfilled.
Yes.
So they should be established or fulfilled.
Fulfilled.
Is fulfilled the same as established?
Opposite.
Is it the opposite?
Yes.
But the pastor told you that he came to set a Christian example. But he said in the book that he came to fulfill. Who you believe? You see that what the Christians have set up is a propaganda, lies and hypocrisy. Mm-hmm. And it's a brainwashed thing. Because he clearly states in the book that he came to fulfill. Your pastor told you previously that he came to establish. Establish is the opposite of fulfill. Right through the scripture kept saying he came to fulfill. Why he came to fulfill? Because he came in his first coming as Joshua, who was Yahshua, to set up those laws, who led Moses and taught Moses the law. In his first coming. So when he came back as Messiah now, he came back still as Yahshua to fulfill them, to bring in the spiritual law. That's why he said that. Because the book says, looking unto Yahshua, Hebrews 4 and 20, who's the author and the finisher. You want to read it for me? Yeah. Hebrews 4 and 20. He's the author. He was the one back there setting up those works, as who they call Joshua, who led Moses. What was Yahshua or Yahushua? So that's the time he said it, but when he came, he said, which shed for many for the remission of sin. But under the Old Testament, whose blood was shed? Cows and goats. So that's why the blotting out and writing of ordinances that was against us. And they were contrary to us. And he took them out of the way. But the pastor didn't tell you that. Nailing them to his cross. So what? Read.
Hebrews 12.
They were going to run the name.
Yes. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2.
Yes.
Looking unto Yahshua.
Looking unto Yahshua.
The author.
The author. What does it mean? When I say author, he's the originator.
And the finisher of our faith.
That's why when he was on the cross, he said it is finished. Because the role he was playing then was the finisher. So when did he play the author? When he led Moses in the mount and gave him the law, he set up that everything back there. And that was 1,500 years before he came as the Messiah. 1,500 years before he came as the author. And this is what the Christians have missed. So the book says he's the author and he's the finisher. What did he say in John 19:30? To show that he's the finisher here.
It is finished.
It is finished. So one point he's playing the author, and the other point he's playing the finisher, but they mix it up. Because they don't have a vision. And that's why the book says we don't have vision.
People perish.
You're too great.
All right, now. So he said it is finished. So he's the finisher. All right, now.
Psalm 40, verse 7 and on. Then said I, Lord,
yes.
I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me.
It is written of me. So you mean that before Jesus made that statement, how Jesus named that in the beginning of the book? He said, I am coming in the volume of the book. It is written of me.
Yes.
Read, but was Yahshua who made that statement?
Psalm 40, verse 8.
Yes.
Psalm, I delight to do thy will, O my Elohim.
Yes.
Yea, thy law is within my heart. Hebrews.
Hurry up, hurry.
Chapter 7. Chapter 5.
All right. So we confirm that he's the finisher. Mm-hmm. All right, look at the King James Version with the names now. When the children of Israel were in Egypt for 430 years, and this is the history.
Chapter 10, verse 7 of the Hebrew.
They were in Egypt being treasure city. And they were in servitude. And they find out that Yahweh told the children of Israel how to get out under the leadership of Moses and Yahushua. They had to take out the lamb. Kill the lamb, put the blood up on the two side post, the upper door post, different from a beast. And that made the configuration of the cross. And they went through the divided water of the Red Sea, and they resurrected. And this is how Israel was drawn out of Egypt, by the name and the gospel. Moses received the name at the burning bush. In the King James Version, verse 10. Let's hear from the King James Version. You be the judge.
Exodus 3 and 10.
Yes.
Come now therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh.
So Moses heard the voice from the bush saying, come now therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh.
That thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel out of Egypt.
Read.
And Moses said unto God.
Now Moses is having a conversation with God. Read.
Who am I?
Who am I?
That I should go unto Pharaoh.
That I should go unto Pharaoh.
And that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt.
Read that.
And he said, certainly I will be with thee.
Yes.
This shall be a token unto thee that I have sent thee.
Read.
Verse 13.
Yes.
And Moses said unto God.
So Moses said unto God.
Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel.
When I come unto the children of Israel.
And shall say unto them.
Yes.
The God of your fathers hath sent me unto you.
Yes.
And they shall say to me, what is his name?
Read.
What shall I say unto them?
Read.
And God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
I am that I am is a limited phrase. Read.
Verse 50.
Yes.
And God said moreover unto Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
Still saying the children of Israel.
The Lord God of your fathers.
Now in the King James Version, he said the Lord God of your father.
The God of Abraham, the God of
Abraham,
and the God of Jacob.
Abraham.
And sent me unto you.
Read.
This is my name forever.
What is Lord God a name?
No.
Ask me my name, Mr. Brown.
What's your name, please?
Teacher, nurse.
Not a name.
Is Lord a name in this case?
No.
And he's confirming that there are two titles. He said that the Lord God is my name forever. But did the Creator say that?
No.
Who is supremely intelligent? He said that stupid person would say, the Lord God is my name. No, he didn't give Moses a name as yet, according to the King James Version, and he put it definitely as it was. Day before, he said, the Lord God is my name. He gave two titles. You have a landlord. If you write a check to your landlord, they put Lord in it?
No.
You have a drugs lord.
Warlord.
A warlord. You have a godmother, godfather. These are two titles. Why did King James put the Lord God is my name forever? And nobody said anything until this vision and revelation came. Lord is not a name. Neither is God a name. So when he saw Yahweh, he changed it to two titles. And you can see definitely that something is wrong. Can I say Mr. Lord?
No.
And Mr. God? He put the definite article. If I come to the school and I want to see a teacher, and I say to the security guard, I want to see the teacher. How many teachers are here? First Corinthians 8 and 5 says, for though there be that are called gods, whether in heaven or in earth, for there be lords, men and gods in heaven. Then they say that the capital G-O-D is the one in heaven. Is some people stupid? No, Father, don't speak plain. I said, repeat those things. I said, God is not capital or common. You tell me. They said that the capital G-O-D, people been to university. And that's why this is not a physical university knowledge. It's the university of Yahshua knowledge. How can I say God and you say capital or common? You're speaking uppercase and lowercase?
No.
Isn't that just for writing?
Yes.
And people keep saying, you know, the capital G-O-D is the one in heaven. So you didn't give me a name. And in Exodus 20 verse 7, he said, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. You shall not take the name of the teacher nurse in vain. But the teacher nurse didn't give me a name. Then in Psalm 68 verse 4, it says, sing praises to God's name. Extolling that right in front of everybody's name, John. But I thought you said that the Lord God was his name forever. Then he says, sing praises to his name. Extolling that right upon the heaven by his name, Jah. It wasn't Jah, it was Yah. They are close. But it is Yah. Now in Matthew 1:21, it says, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, according to the King James Version. When the name was given, the definition was given. Listen. It says, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. But what is the Greek word for savior?
Soter.
Did he say Jesus Soter?
No.
He said Jesus Christ. So where you see these in the Bible, and then he gave them Jehovah, which they say, you know my name, but my name Jehovah. Jehovah is incorrect also, because there isn't a letter J in Hebrew. So that's for the name, the title and the name, Lord God and Jesus Christ and Jehovah. Now, when you do a transliteration on the name, so that is for the King James Version. The Holy Name Version of the Bible, where they see Lord God, read back Holy Name Version now.
Exodus
chapter 3, verse
15. For time, for the visitors. Okay. It says, Yahweh, come on, readers.
Yes.
Holy Name.
And Elohim said, moreover unto Moses.
So this is what was in the original. Elohim is the pluralistic title that Yahweh chose for himself. Read.
Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
And he says, the children of Israel.
Yahweh. The Elohim of thy of their father.
And the Elohim of your father.
The Elohim of Abraham.
Yes, Hebrew man.
The Elohim of Isaac.
Hebrew man.
The Elohim of Jacob.
Yes.
Hath sent me unto you.
Read.
This is my name forever.
Yes, now we get a name. This is my name forever. Read.
And this is my memorial unto all generations.
So that's why Yahweh saying your name is the same throughout all generations.
Yeah.
Just like his name. The name Yahweh stems from the Tetragrammaton. And we're going to transliterate the name for you. Now, English is read from left to right. Hebrew is read from right to left. They write on the consonant. But while they speak, they supply the vowels. Just like you see RD cannot be pronounced unless you add the vowels to it. So while they speak, they supply their vowels. When you do a transliteration, it deals with sound. Yah, give you the sound of the English Y. Hey, H, war, double, pay another A. That is spelling. Yod A, war A is the spelling in Hebrew. When you go to the encyclopedias and look for Yahweh, you will see the name Yahweh. Also, you will see this called the Tetragrammaton. So, look at this now. We arrive at YH, double H in English. Because we have to get back the same thing. Just like when you go to Russia, they have to do the same thing to get back the same sound and meaningfulness. Don't let anybody translate your name. You lose everything. So you are given the sum of the word A-H, word, double A, another H. We were instructed by this divine vision revelation to complete Yahweh in English. So he's speaking about the weaknesses now. Go to the first man, Adam, taking all the one from his name and insert it between the Y and the H to get the masculine portion. Yah. Then we go to the first woman who Yahweh created, who is E. Taking the only word from her name, which is the E, and insert it between the W and the H, we get way. Psalm 150, verse 6. Now, it is Yahweh in Hebrew, and it is the same in English. It is Yahweh in Hebrew, it is Yahweh in Russian. Yahweh in Hebrew, Yahweh in Braille. Yahweh in Hebrew, Yahweh in Japanese. Let's revisit what he said. He is intelligence itself.
Verse 6.
No. In Exodus 3:15, it says, this is my name forever, and this is my reward and the sum.
Oh,
that makes sense. So Michael Jackson is Michael Jackson in our language. Bolt is Bolt in our language. And it's true. And it's his name throughout all generations. Psalm 150, verse 6. Let's go into the weaknesses now.
Let everything that hath breath praise Yahweh.
No, listen to my breath. When I inhale, it says Yahweh, and exhale. Because get me first John 4:9-10, speaking about the weaknesses. Pure lungs. He said, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Can my breath praise the Lord?
No.
Job 27, verse 3 says, all the while my breath is in me, and the spirit of Yahweh is in my nostrils. The word male is M-A. The word female is F-E. The male hormone is called androgen. The female hormone is called estrogen. There's the afferent nerve and the efferent nerve. 23 chromosomes from the male, 23 from the female. When he created the man Adam, the woman was in him. Lord is masculine. Where is the lady? God is masculine and it's a single gender. Jesus Christ is masculine. Jah is masculine. Jehovah is masculine. Jesus is masculine. Christ is masculine. When he said in Genesis, let us make man, was the Lord speaking to God? Where's the feminine counterpart? The reflection of the creation is reflecting the creator. Mm-hmm. In bottom, ganja, male and female. Apple, male and female trees. Animal kingdom, zoology, male and female. You are male and female. How you know that? The egg, the sperm, and the egg. Adam and Eve. Revelation 12. He says, and 7, he says, he saw a woman clothed in the sun. So it's always Yahweh and his bride. Where is the bride here? The heavens declare the glory of Yahweh and the firmament show it is at the works. That's the DNA and this that is available. So if you don't want to receive the witness of Yahweh, the creation is reflecting the creator. He said, man is made in the image and the likeness of the creator. That's what he says. Let us make man. Didn't he say that in Genesis?
That's right.
Let us make man in our image and after our likeness. In other words, the man should look like the creator. The man should do everything like the creator. So the creator said his Yahweh is male and female. How do you get pregnant? Can two men bring forth in the offspring?
No.
Come to the army for Jesus Christ?
No.
Two lesbians, can they have children?
No.
Two homosexuals, can they have
children? No.
It has to be a male and a female.
Very fast.
So you have 23. So when you came into existence, is the sperm united with the egg.
Very fast.
So right there you have male and female. So the prophets came in Isaiah, Zechariah, Obadiah, Zephaniah, and the highest praises?
Hallelujah.
What is the meaning of Hallelujah?
Praise
the people going to university and they can't tell you that enough. What is the meaning of? They study everything about the world and don't study about the reality. So you see, when they talk about this knowledge, it comes like nonsense in some of them. Even though all the sense and the wisdom of Yahweh is in it. What's the meaning of Hallelujah?
Praise the leave too.
And who the praise is going to?
Yahweh.
You ever say Hallelujah, Lord, if you're a Christian saying Hallelujah, Lord, or Hallelujah, God, or Hallelujah. He says every tongue must confess that Yahshua the Messiah is the Savior. To the glory of Yahweh, they are confessing. Mm-hmm. Revelation 22, verse 4 for our visitors. Read me first, John, first about
first
witnesses.
First John, chapter 10, verse 7.
Yes.
For there are three that bear record in
no
heaven.
No doubt. First John 4. First John 4, I'm not ready for that. He said, if you receive the witness of men, because this is the witness of men.
1 John 5:9.
Yes.
If we receive the witness of men.
If we receive the witness of men.
The witness of Yahweh Elohim is greater.
The witness of Yahweh Elohim, Yahshua, is greater.
For this is the witness of Yahweh Elohim.
For this is the witness of Yahweh Elohim.
Which he has testified of his Son.
Yes.
He that believeth on the Son of Yahweh Elohim.
Yes.
Have the witness in himself.
Have the witness in himself. The baby cries. Yeah, yeah. You ever hear the baby cry, Lord God? The baby says, Lord God. Yeah. Jesus. And it's sound like, yeah, yeah. The donkey prays, yeah. It's sound like, Lord God. Nope. It's sound like Jesus Christ to you. Yeah. Never. And you said that the heavens declare the glory of Yahweh and the firmament show his hand. Who made this tree?
Yeah.
It matched to Lord God and Jesus Christ.
No.
Look at the creation of the biggest tree. It branched after the letter Y. Right. Did you know I'm standing on two Y's? Yeah. I have one bone here, two here. One humorous, the other on the radio, so I can make a perfect Y, testifying to Yahweh and Yahshua. This, the infallibility of this teaching is undeniable. And if you deny this, you deny your own existence.
First of all,
that is true. So we're using the witnesses to prove the existence of the Creator.
Yeah.
But you have to receive the witnesses to believe that Yahshua the Messiah is the Savior. It is spelled, Yahshua's name is spelled Yod-A-Y-Shinayim. In the Hebrew, it is pronounced Yahshua. When you do your transliteration, it is still Yahshua. It is Yahshua in Hebrew, Yahshua in Greek, Yahshua in Japanese, in all languages. So Yahshua is the Savior. Finish up the chair.
Yes. 1 John 5:10 continue.
Yes.
He believeth on the Son of Yahweh.
So you have to believe to receive the witnesses.
Have the witness in himself.
Have the witness in himself.
He that believeth not Yahweh.
Yes.
Has made him a liar.
And you shall be damned to make Yahweh a liar.
Because. He believeth not the record that Yahweh gave
of his Son.
And this is the record.
And this is the record.
That Yahweh has given to us eternal life.
That Yahweh has given us eternal life.
And this life is in his Son.
And this life is in his Son, Yahshua the Messiah. Our Revelation 22:4 says, you shall see their face.
And they shall see his face.
Yes.
And his name shall be in their forehead.
All right, read Genesis 1 now, where it says, let us make the man. He said, you shall see his face. Mitchell, you have any marker?
Yes.
And his name shall be in the forehead. Where is the forehead? Is the forehead here or the end
front?
Front. You know, when I was growing up, I thought this was the forehead. But if you ask a doctor, this is the forehead. F-O-R-E-N. It's true. And he said the nail shall be in your forehead. So yeah, Mr. Ford makes a car put forward like Lexus, Bima. So Yahweh said, read Genesis. Let us make man. See, the creator is stupid. He's supreme intelligence. He said, let us make man in our image. Come on.
Genesis 1:26.
Yes.
And Elohim said,
yes.
Let us make man in our image and after our likeness.
So Yahweh, so when you get a book, you put your name on it. You have your check, you put your name on it. You made something, you put my name on it. That one missed you. If you made something, whose name you put on it?
Your name.
So who made the man?
Yahweh.
Sure, for that Yahweh didn't build those churches down here because well, they said that those churches are the temple of the Creator. But I don't see the Creator's name on it.
Mm-hmm.
As it's St. Paul of Palestine. This one, all sorts of different names. I don't see one with the name of the Creator written on it. But watch the one that Yahweh made. Draw the face and put the Y, your eyebrow, making the perfect Y. Your nose, Yahweh A. Your two laugh line and your mouth cut this way. That's Yah. And the W, look at the points of the W. And the E is in the A sideways, and the other lip for the other H. Beat that. There's nothing you can do with that. And the ladies like to shave up the eyebrows, straighten the nose, and paint the lips. Because they are glorifying Yah. They are putting the emphasis on Yah, but they are ignorant of it.
That's right.
And they go and pluck it, and they I see nowadays they're putting on eyelash, and they put on the shaving thing, and they put on a pin on the nose to keep the nose, the nostrils straight, and put lipstick. That's Yah. Now, and he said he put the name in our forehead. No man can take away this name. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, you made the pastor take away Yahweh from your family. You are lost eternally. Because this is your identity, Yahweh and his son. Yahshua, because without the shedding of Yahshua's blood, there is no remission of sin. Jeremiah 23 verse 25, Doc. Yahweh said, I have heard what you Yes, quickly, Doc, so I can, because it...
25.
Yes.
It says, I have heard what the prophet said.
Yahweh said, I have heard what the prophet said.
That prophesied lies in my name.
That prophesied lies in Yahweh's name.
Saying,
I have dreamed.
How long shall this be in the heart of the prophet?
How long shall this be in the heart of the prophet?
That prophesy lies.
That prophesy lies that Lord God and Jesus Christ is the Savior. It's a damnable lie.
They are prophets of the deceit of their own heart.
They are prophets of the deceit of their own heart. They make it a lie.
Which think to cause my people to forget my name.
So they, Lord God and Jesus Christ, the people promoting, the imposters promoting Lord God and Jesus Christ, cause the people to forget the name Yahweh, Elohim Yahshua.
By their dreams, which they tell every man to his neighbor,
saying that Lord God and Jesus Christ is the Savior. And that's a dream. But Yahweh said without a vision, the people perish.
As their fathers.
So this is divination. You want a greater witness than the name in your voice. And the bread said, when I inhale, it says Yah, when I exhale, it says me. And it's the breath of life. What is the name of the creator? Because he says the breath of life, so it's alive. That's what I learned to you.
Impossible.
You see this illusion? And broad is the way that leads to destruction. And the entire world running after Lord God and Jesus Christ. And they have been drunken with the bad wine of Babylon. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angel fought against the dragon. And the dragon fought on his angels. They are blasphemous. And they are going to pay in the lake of fire. To blaspheme Yahweh's name, his temple, and his tabernacle. What? Knowing not that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. He said he doesn't dwell in temples. Read it for me.
Just finishing this.
Finish that now.
As their fathers have forgotten my name for Baal.
So Baal, Lord, is Baal. Popular name for the title for the devil. Their fathers forgotten the scripture fulfilling your presence today. In the visitor's presence. You have forgotten the name of Yahweh for Baal, Lord, is Baal. And Yahweh says he'll take away the name of Baal out of your mouth. But once you were ignorant, you will not even know that you heard that is Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua, you should repent. And don't call him Lord, that's an insult to you. You cannot call Queen Elizabeth Lady or a King Lord. Why you want to call King Yahshua Lord Jesus? Yeah. You're trying to dethrone him. That's the mission of the devil. But he has failed because Yahshua has resurrected gloriously. And Yahweh says in the book in Isaiah 53 that my people shall know my name.
Right.
In Isaiah
52,
read it. And God got to the fulfillment while Mitchell is getting that.
Isaiah 52 and 6.
Yes.
And it says, therefore, my people shall know my name.
He didn't say, therefore, my people shall know my title as Lord God. He didn't say, when Moses asked for the name, he gave two titles. He said, my people shall know my title. He said, my people shall know my name.
Therefore, they shall know in that day that I am he.
That I am he. That God speaks. Behold, it is Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua. Matthew 1:21. He said, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Yahshua. Watch this. See. The father is Yahweh, and the son is Yahshua. He came in his father's name. He bore the masculine portion of the father's name. The Father is Yahweh, and the Son is Yahshua. What is the meaning of Shua?
Salvation.
Salvation says that Yahweh will be our salvation. Now, Jesus Christ came as Jesus Christ. Is Jehovah Jehovah Christ? Mm-hmm. Says whose name he came in? Furthermore, the nationalities, they are different. So Yahweh, and they like to say that Yahweh is Hebrew. What is it, people adopt? We're teaching you the right, you know, don't listen to don't speak. Can you look at these English characters and call them Hebrew?
Yes
or them not?
English letters.
And that is really nonsense. How do you want to look at YAHWEH and call that Hebrew? Isn't this English?
Yeah.
I say these dunce people spreading propaganda. Why are they doing this? Because they are not taught by the Holy Spirit. And they are in eternal darkness. Yahshua says, know the truth, and the truth will bring you free. When he was in the Garden of Gethsemane the night before his crucifixion, he said, and this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true Elohim, and Yahshua the Messiah whom thou art sent. Salvation is predicated on the knowledge of our Savior. It's the knowledge. How is your soul sustained by what and by whom? By going to church and physically what? Baptizing the physical body?
Knowledge of Yahshua.
And eating physical Passover? If you drink a cup of water, is your soul drinking water?
No.
Is your soul alive?
Yes.
How is it kept? How is it sustained by what and whom? How does it eat?
Yahshua.
You remember when the devil went to Yahshua and said that I commanded that you turn this stone, this same stone by Jordan there, to bread? Why won't he turn stone into bread? Because this stone covenant, he has turned it into bread 2,000 years expired, feeding the people dead bread. What did Yeshua say to the devil? Man shall not eat by bread.
Verse 4 of Matthew 4. Then the tester came to Yeshua and said, if thou be the Son of Yahweh, command that these stones be made bread. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone.
But that's what they feed you in the church.
But by
every word
that
bread
that proceedeth out of the mouth of Yahweh.
We say, but by every word. Job 34 and 3. But by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of Yahweh Elohim. So what does the soul